Oh, whiz. What am I reviewing today with you on the background? I mean, oh, shit. I did not expect to see you here. Hello. This is an Emotiva S8 subwoofer, I believe is the name of it. And it's going to help us not lose our minds. It's going to help a lot of you, I think, not lose your minds. You see, a lot of times you got a desk set up. This is not a room sub. Like, it's a room sub, but it's like not a 0.1 sub. So I'm not even going to bother with, like, in my living room at home theater. Because it's only an 8. But it's an Emotiva 8, which means it's got Emotiva amps, which means it's got an Emotiva design. And it's got some features that I think are going to be real interesting to anyone putting a 2.1 at a desk. So, because they're still on my table, these fucking boring, baseless audio engine 5 pluses. I don't really enjoy their sound. But I could help it out a great deal by adding a sub. So I've had a couple subs lying around that I could integrate, but you know, it's a pain in the ass. Because to do subs right, you gotta do all this other shit. And that other shit used to require a mini DSP or a surround receiver or something. But this is a special subwoofer. This is the first I've ever seen of its kind. So that's worthy of the desk, right? It's worthy of a whiz wallpaper, Chimotsky, whatever. It's worthy. Let me show you the sub. All right, let's take off the covers first. Well, the cover. It doesn't quite have the same Emotiva like angularity that a lot of their bigger things do. It's just a sub box. You take this cover off and you lose all the specialness of the shape. It's just in these corners are routed back. So you get it's a nice little feature. I like it. I like that you don't have any logos up here. It doesn't say Emotiva anywhere on it. It doesn't say Emotiva on this. You can put it on in any orientation and it still fits. Let's put this to the side. Actually, you know what? We can't put this to the side. We're going to need to use this. So I have to turn this thing. The first reason that this is an interesting subwoofer. Reason number one. Front firing 8-inch. Down firing 8-inch passive radiator. No port. One of the big problems with a small subwoofer is when you really start hammering it, that hole is going to go, and it's going to chuff. That's called chuffing. Don't go chuffing with your friends after school. It sounds like you're playing like a choo-choo train game. Like, hey, everybody, hoo-hoo. So that's unique automatically. You don't see many passive radiator subs in general. My living room, the 10-inch Infinities are passive radiator subs. And I love them because when this driver goes in and out, this driver goes in and out. And there's no air that's going, so they're silent, or at least they don't have any added things. Big old feet does have to keep them off the floor, though, because there is excursion here. But that isn't even the entire reason that I'm excited about the subwoofer. That's a wonderful thing. Like the 12-inch, they're 50. I think all their subwoofers are this sort of design, and that's spectacular. Now, the reason you're all here is because this is the easiest sub in the world to integrate into a 2.1 desk setup. And I mean that. Because if we look here, going past all the grease from me being Italian, looks basic so far. Power on, off, phase 0, 180. That's a timing thing. That's it. When you just basically would turn that one way, try it, and turn it the other way and see what sounds better. Because it's a distance. When it goes bump instead of bump, that's what that switches. So it's a timing thing. Power on or auto. There's really no off because that's your off. You get a volume from min to max. You get a crossover from 60 to 150. And you know, that's it. You're done. Go home. Plug your source in. Oh, but wait, Zeos. But wait. So you got an LFE in. So if you did want to put this in a small room in a home theater, you would use that port and that would be it. You just plug it in your LFE to one single RCA and you'd be done. It also has dual RCA inputs. Great. That's great. It also has dual RCA outputs. Okay. So like you can go from your DAC, and I'm using the Topping D30 here, or E30. And we can just plug the Topping E30. Which one is the Topping E30? This one. To the input. And that's what we could do. We could do that right now. And then you could plug your speakers, presumably powered monitors. They wouldn't necessarily be these audio engines, but any powered monitors, Atom T5Vs, Atom T7Vs, you could even use Swan, something like a pre-made speaker, and you could plug those in. I'm going to pull those in a second. However, we got to look at something else. I've never in my life seen a switch like this on the output RCAs. 60, 80, 100 hertz. This subwoofer does what receivers and mini DSPs have been required to do forever. It takes your source input from your RCAs and it will remove the low end. See, one of the reasons you add a subwoofer is because your speakers can't produce the low end. But another reason you would add a subwoofer in like a home theater is you don't want the speakers to even try. Because the speakers have to work really hard. Amps have to work really hard to try to get 30 hertz out of it. I'm trying so hard, boss. And it just, it distorts and you lose volume and it's bad. This does in a very, very easy maneuver, and you can't bypass, which is another, I'd rather have a bypass too, but you can set it to allow 60 hertz to pass through to the speakers, or only 80 hertz and above to pass through to the speakers, or if you have really dinky speakers like these are, 100 hertz. Now 100 hertz and below for the entire system is reliant on this subwoofer. That's what makes this worthwhile. That switch is the game changer. Because you can't just do what I just did. I mean, you can get like little passive crossover things that go in line, but then they really kill the volume. And this will reamplify the volume, because I know if I unplug this, it dims. So it's reamplifying your signal to go to your speakers and cutting out the frequencies you don't want to go to your speakers. Now, this system only works. Hold on, plugging things in. Oh. This system only works, try not to smash my monitor with it either, with the RCA inputs. There are speaker terminal ins or five-way binding posts, which, you know, are just speaker terminal ins. And the other reason this is an exciting subwoofer is it doesn't just do RCA inputs, it's got full speaker terminals. And you're like, Zeos, do I have to run my amp into that? Yes, but here's the thing. When you see this on a subwoofer, a self-powered subwoofer that takes a power input, these are not to power the speaker. These are just to taste what your amplifier is doing to your speakers and then reproduce it. So it won't do what I just described where it takes away the signal. But if you didn't have powered monitors like T5Es and you were just running a set of, say, RB42s on a, let me think, what's the best amplifier for RB42s? Well, SMSL SA300 or SMSL DA8S, which I will all link in the description, you would run your speaker wire like you normally do from the amp to the speakers. What you'd have to do is get other speaker wire, could be cheap, could be fucking 23 gauge, it could be little tiny things, and hook them from the amp, split the amp out, either use banana plugs on the thing and then use regular wire and wire it to this. These don't have a pass-through. If they had a pass-through, this would be so much easier. If you're using raw wire, you could literally run two runs into this. One goes to the amp, one goes to the speaker. This just has to touch the back of your amplifier. Hell, you could even run to the speakers and have the speakers come out and run down to this. As long as it's somewhere in line, touching the signal, this subwoofer knows what to do. And then you just control the volume on your normal amp. And this will go up and down just with everything. You would have set this volume, and then you just set this volume, you hear the speakers, you set the volume to match, and then you're good. It's what we're gonna do right now, because I'm about to put this in line on the desk. So this has the most hookup options of any subwoofer I've ever reviewed. And there are some ones with like AES balance connectors, but I'm not gonna count those. Who the fuck uses that shit? As far as usability, this sub is king. You could fit so much bass into this fucking car. I'm sorry, is the slaps meme done? Yeah, it's probably done. So I'm gonna plug this in. I'm gonna turn it on, yeah. Okay. Shit, I really should have some copyright-free music because this is gonna take forever. I am using the Topping E30, which has a remote for the volume. Which is good because you need a remote for the volume, because once you establish something like this system, like, yeah, there's a volume knob here, which will raise and lower the volume. And there's a volume knob here, which will raise and lower the bass volume. But you don't want to be dicking around, especially if you get like a set of individual powered monitors, you don't want to reach behind them to adjust it. So you need some sort of preamp. You could use a Shit Sis. You could use Myga Origen, G2, if you really wanted to. Those are the oldest revisions. But this is beautiful and new and shiny. And unfortunately, it doesn't have a volume control on the front of it. You have to use a remote. But we're at negative 50, and I know I can go higher than that. So hold on. We go like 28 decibels. You could actually hear when I flip the switch, if you can. I don't know if the Hero 8 could pick it up, but if I'm going to go from 60 hertz right now to 100, you should hear a little bit of that drop away. Or I should unpause it. Down, down. It just thins out. It's taking more and more away from those speakers because you're bad. You're bad, baby. You don't know how to do low end. You'll be fine. You'll be okay because I have the big black guy here is going to help you. This guy right here, he's going to help you. But I'm going to watch. All right. Let's do 80 because 80 is the THX cutoff. So we're going to do 80 hertz to the speakers and 80 hertz down to the sub. So that's what that's it. We're set. I'm going to leave the phase at zero because I think we're pretty much in phase with it right now. You have to set the crossover here as well. So if I set that to 80, I should probably set this to 80, and it's not marked. It goes 60 to 150. And don't think that you have to set it specifically to the... it's all by ear. There's a reason they don't mark what the individual things are. You don't set it to 80 and then go exactly to 80, and it's fine. You've got to blend it. You've got to find where these things were. It's all about the fine tuning. I can't help you. My ears are not in your house. You okay back there, Wiz? My ears are not there to help you. You have to take responsibility for tuning things. Where is this subwoofer going in your room? Did you do the sub crawl? I would highly recommend if the sub crawl tells you to put it in the other fucking corner, don't go extending RCA cables 20 feet. Keep these to under 6 to 8 feet length and you'll be happy. Just find that. By the way, I love these. These are the world's best cables and they literally are. Although I ignore these flags and remove them mostly because there's source direction and that's bullshit. Electrons don't fucking care. They're also fraying. So now that we have it hooked up on the desk, now that we can mute that, we can unpause that, go to another track that actually might have low end. I don't want to kill myself in this desk either. Star Wars. Ooh, the Fix. That's not bad. I don't know if it's going to have low end. But we're going to... I can't see the track. Come on. Nero, that'll have low end. 2808, war was beginning. Wow. Wow, you suck. This feels like I should just restart this video because I'm having such bad luck with this. God damn it. Where's my dead mouse? I'm going to Dead Mouse, everyone. I hope you enjoy sitting here watching me find fucking Dead Mouse and anger. Obsidian? I don't know that song. Not being able to see my progress bar is really annoying. Perfect. Perfect. So that's set to 28. I'm going to put that there. Oh, baby. And now I can mute that. Let's take this off so we can watch it dance. I'm gonna watch you dance, baby. I'll never find that again. It'll be weeks. Move you over. Now that I've seen what I'm doing here, there's Wiz. There's this. It's not pause, it's muted. Of course, I can't see it. So, our job is to blend the two together. So we have our volume there, whatever it is. Usually what I would tell you to do is set it to its absolute maximum. Just set whatever volume that you have to maximum. Turn everything else down and then turn the master volume up. And then play a loud ass song, the loudest fucking song you know. And then put in the speakers to the point where you are done. That is as loud as they should ever get. Because we have this limiter here. This is basically the limiter. If we do this, if I lower this all the way down, and I lower this all the way down, and we put that to zero, we're still getting sound because it's... Can we get to the loudest part of the song? Perfect. Ow. All right. let's lower that a little bit, I think. Yeah, this subwoofer, by the way, kicks much ass. Holy fuck. Did anyone witness the mouse doing its thing? Let me go back up to like... I'm gonna mute that now. One of the big problems with... can't lower it. A really good device to raise and lower volume when you mute something will let you lower it without unmuting. Up will unmute it because it doesn't want you to go to zero while it's muted. That's bad. But it'll mute lower and then let you unmute it. This does not do that. So that's just an overlook. But so what we have now is a completed system, a completed 2.1. The speakers will never go past zero and blow up because I just set them to the loudest that DAC will handle. Is zero. These are turned. If we glue this knob in place, you can glue this knob in place. You're done touching it. Never touch it again. And I think it's blending out real nice. So I could even, let's try it with, let's take 100 hertz off and just unmute that. See, I just put it to 60, and I feel like we're getting too much from the sub at that point. No, wait, did I set it to 60? Yeah, I set it to 60. We're getting too much from the speakers. I want thinner speakers, more sub. These speakers are that, so they need that sort of fix. Oh. I hear things rattling. I don't recommend, by the way, this is not the position for this subwoofer. Do not put it here. As much as you are a bass head, this is no good. Trust me on this. Let's look at the bottom. I can turn it on its side. Hold on. Gently. It's not that heavy, but it's enough. Just beauty. I'm probably not going to get monetized. Please support this channel via Patreon and subscribe, or else I'll have to stop playing music. And that would suck. Because I'm not going to play fucking... CEOs, why don't you play, copyright-free music? Because it sucks. Unless you have really good copyright-free music, then feel free to tell me in the comments. I might look into it, but I really just want to, like... I want people to say, oh, Deadmau5 is playing. What did he put on? He put on One Trick Pony. And then he went to that exact moment where you know it is. Yeah, no, this is a murderous sub. That's another thing. It's $300. $300 is not cheap. I can point out 12-inch subs you can get for $300. The Bic America F12 you can get for $300. And it will probably have slightly more output than this. But this has no port, so you're automatically guaranteed they'll never be chuff. Those options to hook up in the back, which have never existed before, and it's Emotiva, so you know the amplifier is not like... You always question when you get like a random Chinese sub. Like, Bic is Bic, but it's Bic. It's like... The amplifiers in this are Emotiva amplifiers, number one. So you're paying for that. And you're paying so that if something goes wrong, you call a customer service department. I think they're located in somewhere in the South. It's America, that's for sure. Nashville? It's not Nashville. I forget where they are, but there's definitely, they are here. You're paying for that. And it's for a person doing a desktop setup, a 2.1, no matter what your monitors are. Here's the thing. Yeah, I'm fixing the lackluster nature of these audio engines. But even if you have a really good set of studio monitors or speakers, because you got to remember, this works for both. It has a speaker turn. It works for both. I would hook this up, but it's a pain in the dick to get the wire. You got to undo that. You got to put the piece of wire in there. You got to close it. You got to bring it up. You got to go behind your... Actually, this is a speaker amp. I could wire to this. And you got to wire it in there. Don't ground anything out. Everything's got to be separate, but it can... This does not take any ohms off the speaker. It doesn't change the dynamics of it. You just have to make it touch this. The amp has to touch the speakers, and the amp has to touch the sub. It's not powering the sub. It's just telling it what's the volume and what's the signal it needs to play. So you can integrate that in like 2 seconds. It could all be done on the back of the amp if you really felt like it, with banana plugs and raw wire. Just both of those will usually work. Just like this. So I'm impressed. I'm impressed. I know their 12-inch that I have in the other room doesn't have these same options, which is unfortunate because I know a lot of people who are bass heads, and what you could do, because you're assholes, is you could buy two of these because you could just run the left-hand side through and out, and then the right-hand side through and out, and have 4 8-inch drivers pummeling you, like making the mice shake across your desk, which is obviously what's going to happen here. And it does add that also the effect of, since this is pushing down against the floor, you get an actual shake. Like, it doesn't just make it sound in the corner. It is hammering. The SVS 13-inch that was a tube was fucking murderous. And this has a little bit of that. This is shaking the desk because it's doing both directions. It goes both ways. I'm very, 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 very pleased with this. Not just its performance, but its hookup options are just... I've never seen another sub that does that. And I kind of wish they made a 10, because an 8 will do this room. This room is pretty big. It's got a big alcove over here, and it will destroy this room. But if you get a little bit bigger room, you get like an office space, you might want a 10 or two of these. But then you're looking at $600, and at that point, you're looking at one of their bigger subs. Actually, let me look real quick before I end this video, because, I mean, I can't play anymore. I could just mute the speakers and then unmute. Everything under this table is just destroying itself. Oh my God. You know, that was a bad idea. I don't recommend putting it on a plastic table. Yes, I use plastic tables. Suck it. Biggest audio YouTuber, plastic table, that's the key. $299, no reviews. I think I'm gonna go give this a fucking 5-star right now and be the first to write a review. Yes, sir, I think I will. However, if you look at their other subs, the one I have in the other room is that one, the Airmotive S12, which is $700. And it also has a down-firing 12, front-firing 12, down-firing 12, murder. There's a 15-inch, I don't think that has a down-firing, I'm not sure, that's $800. There's the Airmotive RS13 Reference, which is a single 13-inch, that's $1,600, I gotta get that one. That's the real one, that's the one I wanna know about. This was a pleasant surprise, it sits here, $300, I wouldn't even have looked at it. I was like, well, who cares about that? But down-firing 8, front-firing 8, and those hookup options, sold. Anyone doing a 2.1 at a desk, this is all I'm going to recommend for you now. Because it's been several years since my absolute favorite 8-inch sub existed. This is it, by the way. I looked for subwoofers on Amazon. And nothing here competes. There's the Bic America, by the way, $210. Save $100, but you don't get that switch. And it's bigger. But that isn't necessarily better. Plus, you get the port chuff. And just ignore that Audio Engine S8 I reviewed that. It was not worth $350. Holy fuck, was that not worth $350. My favorite 8-inch subwoofer of all time was the Martin Logan Dynamo 300. I own two of them. They're part of my Doomstack towers that have subwoofers in the base. And this is the closest thing I have to bringing back that sort of magic. It's way more money. It's double the price, but... it's doing things. It's doing lots of things. So anyway, check that out. Wiz, how you doing? Oh, you can download Wiz in the description of this video. You can also download every wallpaper I've ever done ever on Patreon and Subscribestar. I'm gonna shut this off. Patreon and Subscribestar, where you can see these reviews early, up to a week at a time sometimes. Ask me any questions you want on platform and participate in the yard sales. I don't believe Emotiva is letting me keep this, so you're just here on a loner, baby. Then you're gonna go back home. Someone else is gonna buy you used. That's so cool. Oh my God, I'm so glad it fucked in. Anyway, that $10 Patreon chat exists, Telegram. You can ask me any questions you want there all the time. Like, you don't have to wait. Yard sales I already talked about. See these views earlier I already talked about. Hi-fi guides and the forum. There is a subwoofer section. We just added a home theater section to hi-fi guides here. So where is it? Home theater, speakers, home theater subs. Currently zero things in the home theater subs category. Feel free to go in there and start filling some out, or I'll do it. I mean, I should probably do it. It's probably my site. Whatever. I'll get to it. I'm getting around to it. Thank you, Emotiva, for fucking providing something that actually has interest to me. Look how cool that Switch is. This Switch saves you from having to get a home theater receiver or a mini DSP. A mini DSP is what I would usually tell you. I'll get powered monitors and use a mini DSP HD. That's 200 extra fucking bucks. 200 extra dollars. Or just buy the subwoofer. That's a little bit more money. So you could do that. It's perfect. It's perfect solution. It's perfect fucking perfect solution.